Roger!
The Wonderful 101.
Remind me of myself at your age, Blue. Reckless, hot-headed, knows more than anyone.
Dude, you risked the ship for me.
Some of you are more high-maintenance than others.
Look, I'm putting my life on the line out there. You expect me to listen to some wuss teacher playing dress-up after all I've lost?
Playing dress-up? You're not the only one who's lost family in this war, Blue.
Huh?
I can still close my eyes and see Red's father being gunned down. I was there, you know, 20 years ago.
Mothership with your new missile and the battle's over, right? Give me some good news, Shirogane.
You betcha! Give her a whooping with my digital pandemic missile and them conduction viruses will spread across their dummy network faster than you can say file not found.
I have absolutely no idea what you just said, but that's good enough for me. Best get this thankless business over with. I owe either one. I'm here to get you out of this mess. This makes us even.
Nelson!
What? Your boy snuck on board again? Will's still a big fan of jets and guns, I see.
I'm bigger than you think!
The enemy strike destroyed the missile guidance system. I've already evacuated the crew. Listen to me, Larry. Get my boy to safety. Staying here is the only chance I have of getting this done. Now quick, into an escape pod with you.
No, Dad! I'm not leaving you!
Will!
Get him out of here, Arthur. You can finally owe me one for a change.
Don't be a fool, Larry. Even your Sentinel suit won't withstand that blast wave. This is my job.
Arthur!
Loosen up, Vermin! Time to take out the trash!
Dad!
Where are you hiding, little mousey? What? Did you watch your daddy die? Want revenge?
Wonder Eyes Red! Hey, how about you pick on someone your own size?
You have to go on alone. This is it for me.
Arthur.
Nelson, our future's in your hands. Take care of my boy.
No! Let go! Let go of me!
Thank you. dad. Oh, wow.
Unfortunately, my costumed comrades, our playdate is at an end. But don't worry, you can still play with my toys.
Here. We need to take out the cannon first.
Red saw his father murdered before his very eyes. He blamed himself for not trying to do more to save him, for not living up to his own ideals. When Red joined the Sentinels, he told me he was prepared to face any hardship, that he would never shy away from battle. An admirable sentiment for any wonderful one, but there was more. He said he considered his work as a teacher part of his mission, that he would strive to give his students the strength to bear any burden, to pursue the future his father believed in. Everyone has their own reasons for fighting, Blue. But never forget, the wonderful 100 are a team. One for 100, 100 for all. You are many, but you are one.
It's time for the big climax, little boy Blue!
Whoa!
Blue, you are okay! Imorta's awesome robot just saved you! Is that not so, Imorta?
Yeah.
Dude.
Curses! How dare you bacteria damage my precious mech!
Not this time, Vajon!
Alice, full speed!
Main engine at maximum.
Team, unite up!
Roger!
Blue!
Unite Sword!
You are to become the Greater Galactic Coalition.
What?
My dear Blue, did I just see you cooperate? You, the charge first, plan later, lone wolf? Are you feeling quite well? A fever, perhaps?
No, just a big French headache. Morta, nice work back there.
Huh?
Our thing is teamwork. You work for the group, never against it. You feel me?
Blue,
Hey, one more thing. I want you guys to deck me. Hard. I deserve it.
Pardon?
Don't worry about the pardon. Let's just say I need a wake-up call. No holding back, okay?
But Blue, such violence. No, this I cannot be doing.
And the yellow might break a nail.
I think this shows spirit, does it not? In fact, it presents an opportunity for which I have long waited. Now, Chester, chin up. Hands behind your back. Teeth clenched.
Wait, Monsieur Green. As leader, I relieve the team of this request and take it upon myself.
Oh, but it was to be my pleasure.
Go for it, Red. If you pull your punch, I'll know.
Oh, jeez, bro. Could have pulled a little.
That was very impressive, Red. A thing of beauty unparalleled.
Sorry to steal your moment, Monsieur Green. I'm sure you'll get your chance.
Oh, no. It was your prerogative, of course. I dare say I could do no better. And please, call me Green, Monsieur Rouge.
Enough chit-chat. Wonderful 100, move out!
You bet, boss.
Ugh, men. Always a mystery.
Thank you.
is that?
Is that writing?
Yeah, it says, I wait at the summit. Signed, Prince Vorkin. It's in Relowian.
What's that? Vorky? Waiting for me? I must look a fright. I have to redo my makeup!
This Relowian is what exactly?
It's the language spoken on the comet Vorkin. And by call home. Or called home. Until Gethjerk destroyed it.
Whoa. The jerks get around.
Immorta, can you tell us more?
The comet Rulo was a beautiful world. Verdant, rich, forever voyaging across the deepest reaches of space. Vorkin was born to the royal family of Rulo. As a young prince, he was kind and wise.
Oh, a young prince! Oh my god, that is too precious!
Can you pipe down? I'm trying to listen! He was everything our people could want in a ruler. Our comet's pride. Eyes that looked upon the weak with charity. And a pure heart that suffered no evil. He was our protector. But our comet's peace was shattered when Gethjerk invaded 10 years ago. The people rose up with Vorkin at their head, leading the charge against wave after wave of enemy forces. You see, Vorkin had studied the arts of combat from a young age, and was a capable warrior. Yet Gethjerk's numbers were far too many, and our defenders too few. One by one, they fell. Soon, all of Rulo was overrun, her helpless citizens slaughtered as they fled. Not even the royal family was safe. Mercilessly, they were slain. Vorkin's lord father, his mother, and the love of his life.
Wait a minute! What was that last part you said? You did not say love, did you? Tell me you did not say love!
Risking his own life to protect me, ensuring I safely reached the escape ship. And then, looking back from space as Rulo glowed bright like a ball of celestial flame. One last, brilliant flash, and she was gone. I didn't know what became of our protector after that. It was not until many years later, after I had joined the Galactic Federation police to pursue Gethjerk, that I again saw him as he is today. A merciless raider. Pillager of worlds, with eyes that burn like flame. The prince I once knew is gone. Now only Vorkin, the space pirate, remains.
Oh, Vorkin.
That since the new girl story sounded, how you say, a bit like Swiss cheese.
From crown prince to nomad pirate. Yeah, that's classy.
Please, you would not look classy if it walked up and wrapped its manicured fingers around your neck and throttled you, you little punk!
Be careful, Blue! The girls, they are quite scary!
Spreading his own misery to others. He must be stopped at once!
Mama! See what I mean?
Don't worry, Immorta. We got the message, and we know how to stop Vorkin now. If we can keep them from drawing energy from their shark ship, they won't be able to repair, and they'll be ours.
What? You mean you hadn't realized this before?
Huh? Don't tell me there's another only way to stop them.
No. I think you guys can handle it. Actually, I know you can.
Okay.
Am I the only one not seeing what she's seeing?
It's time you face Vorkin and end this.
Roger.
Been better.